evening. A three-day-old battle raging in Vietnam's central highlands may well have signaled a dramatic change in the character of the Vietnam War. Notably absent from the fighting are the original combatants of that war, South Vietnamese forces and Viet Cong guerrillas. What is going on now is a major confrontation between American troops with their massive air support and the crack regiments of North Vietnamese soldiers. The communists hold a tactical advantage, occupying the ridges and the slopes of Chu Phong Mountain. They encircle Americans' first cavalry positions in Yadrang Valley, 1,700 feet below. The battle, only 5 miles from Cambodia's border, already has become the bloodiest of the war. At least 860 North Vietnamese have been killed, primarily through their human wave attacks and U.S. B-52 bombing strikes. But it's believed the communists still have 6,000 to 8,000 more troops operating in those mountains, many of them recent reinforcements from the north. American officials continue to describe their losses as moderate. But today, fresh troops had to be flown in by helicopter to reinforce survivors of the estimated 800-man 1st Cavalry unit that's been pinned down in that valley since Sunday. And tonight, an American officer with that unit said, "I hope we have not stayed too long." By the way, the
Second General Utbaugh has called on both sides in the Vietnam War to make major concessions in order to make negotiations possible. In a luncheon speech, Plant referred obliquely to a report that the United States rejected a peace proposal from him a year ago. He said, "If only bold steps had been taken in 1964, much of today's tragic developments could have been avoided." Plant said the only alternative to mutual concessions would be prolongation and escalation of the war. Almost as Utbaugh spoke, that escalation was starkly outlined on the battlefield itself. For the first time, American ground forces collided directly and exclusively with North Vietnamese regulars. No South Vietnamese troops, no Viet Cong guerrillas. In this three-day battle of Tu Phong near the Cambodian frontier, the Americans scored a clear victory, smashing an entire regiment of the enemy with communist losses estimated at 1,300 dead. But the cost was high. American casualties are listed officially as heavy, and they don't very often do that. This film of American forces in action near Chu Phong was shot as the battle was getting underway. The howitzers are zeroed in on the enemy rear, 12 miles away. As in most of these actions, it is the helicopters that have done heroic action and service taking out the wounded. The courage and the efficiency of the medics in this war has saved the lives of uncounted wounded by getting them to field hospitals quickly. Up in the front lines, it's hard to know whether the battle is won or lost, or even for that matter, how it's going. But in this war, it is considered progress merely that there is a definable front line, and that more and more, when it is possible, the enemy is being made to fight on our terms. The capture of prisoners is still an extremely tricky business. The enemy is not only elusive, he is treacherous, but his information is essential.